started with a tune called Doxy. It became a jazz standard after it was recorded by Sonny Rollins and Miles Davis, and it featured Devin Schersel and Keegan Chevrier on saxophone solos. Up next, we have a tune called Nzembo na Mola Zamba. It's based off of the traditional African chant from the Bendito Baby tribe in Zaire. So it's going to feature lots of different short rhythmic patterns repeated multiple times. And it was written by Fred Stern, who's a longtime jazz professor at Lawrence University in Appleton. And this is going to feature Taylor Weissensel and Chris Remaker. Last tune of the evening is a tune called Boogie Lou. It's in the style of Boogie Lou rock, which was really popular in the 1960s. It's going to feature a couple of solos, cool animals,
Samba TK. It was written by Mark Taylor. The Samba style originated in Brazil. It was founded by African slaves. What they did was they listened to the sound of polka music and waltzes, and they started to mess with the rhythms and get more a lot more syncopation into their music. The music was not necessarily welcomed into everyday culture right away because it was deriving from the slaves. So they would gather in houses and areas where they could just get together and make their own music. So that is where the Samba came from. Our it also featured, sorry, I almost completely forgot about that. On alto sax, we had Robbie Horner. Trumpet, we had Grace Arbery. Who's putting her on drum kit? Our next tune is a jazz ballad written by Duke Ellington, entitled In a Sentimental Mood. This was very appropriate for jazz music. Jazz was often, there would be a big dance, and then after that dance there would always be an after party. So Duke Ellington claims that he took and played a big dance in a tobacco warehouse. And it was at the after party that he came up with this little tune that became such an iconic song. So this is In a Sentimental Mood, featuring Matt Sheridan on drum. Thank you. Alex Wiedenzel was our tenor sax. Our last tune here is named after a club in Midtown Manhattan. It is the definition of New York elegance and is one of the town's most iconic venues. Charlie Bird Parker dubbed this club the jazz corner of the world. It was at this club that Joe Zawinul got his inspiration for this tune, and when he was listening to countless famous jazz players such as Count Basie, Louis Armstrong, Duke Ellington, and Miles Davis. This tune will also feature our bass player, Vinnie Ryan.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for coming out, everybody. We will see you for our spring concert after we get back from Disney.